game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Welcome back, and we are into our final segment with KK here, and we're all talking about Express Football Club. We've talked the history, we've talked the realities and what it is right now, and in this segment I would love for us to look at what the future holds for Express FC, at least the near future. But before we do that, I did get to sign off from the last segment with a particular question, and maybe let me get to put it to KK now. KK, Express survived on the final day of the league, and it was jubilation across the city, I've gotten to say, and there were neutrals that were actually celebrating your survival. Would you still have taken on this mantle if Express had actually gotten relegated, if events had not turned out the way they did? Because hey, like we said, it had to be sorted on the last day. If on that last day Express went down, were you still going to take over as chairman?
Like I told you, for me, the issue of being an Express fan, and one of the things that I must tell you is that wherever Express will be, I will go with it. Even if it went the Elgon, whether it went further down, I'll still go with it. I don't think there's any other club. Not I don't think. There's no other club that I can possibly support. And even if Express remained with only three players, I'll still stay with them. I think I would have taken it up even if we had gone down.
Would it have been a better situation or a worse situation in your opinion?
I think, you know, there's a dark cloud on every silver, there's a silver lining on every dark cloud. I think the best thing that has happened to Express in the last couple of seasons, last couple of years, is that scare.
Facing relegation.
Facing relegation was an opportunity for us to soul search. Where have we gone wrong? What has happened to us? I mean, we were on top for so long, it became so obvious we were going to stay there. We became complacent. Now, all of a sudden, these things happen to you, and all of a sudden, you say, no, maybe I need to do things different. I need to review what I am doing. And I think we've gotten there, and I think that was the better because we'd have played out one season, but probably it would have drilled into our heads better an understanding of how we have not done well. And I think that scare of relegation is the one thing that coalesced all the Express fans again together to say, oh my God, this can actually happen. We need to reorganize ourselves.
Or maybe so they wouldn't have approached you.
No, I think they didn't have to approach me because, like I said, 2 years on, I'd been looking at Express and trying to figure out what can be done. It was actually the soul searching was about what is the solution to our current predicament. And I think the solution we figured out, we think we have figured it out, but it's something we are trying out. Let's see if it works. So far it's working, but it's there's still so many moving parts which need to be put together so that it can be complete, so we know that the solution has actually been found. But I think one of the things that we must deal with at Express, even as we go into determining where we are going, is to be disciplined in all forms of our thing. We must have financial discipline. We must have books of accounts. We must have accountability. We must be accountable. We must be transparent. Yeah? What is this that is going on where you have partners you can't disclose, you have money you can't share? What is going on? You can't run institutions like that. You must be transparent, you must be accountable. Now, Express is accountable to several groups of people. It's accountable to its partners who are putting in the money. That's the first. It is accountable to the fans. The fans may not put in money, but they come to the stadium. So you're accountable to them.
And in one way they put in the money by buying that ticket.
But you're accountable to history. This is the oldest, biggest club in the country. You're accountable to them. But most importantly, you're accountable to those young players who go out onto the pitch to slug it out for Express. Now, if you can't give them an opportunity, if you cannot be accountable to them, there's no point. So in this period, we want to emphasize that transparency, accountability, and corporate governance. It must be clear. How do you approach Express? Does KK decide who supplies football boots? Does KK decide who supplies food? If that's how Express is working, then we have a problem. How do you determine these things? Are we going for the best available option? How do we achieve the best available option? That is where we need to go. Once we are accountable to that, then we can get to the next stage of saying, now come and work with us. These partners of ours have taken great faith. It's a leap of faith in this thing, because you find this thing has no structure. KK has no history in football management. There are no structures in place, and they are throwing money at you. That's a responsibility. So you have to be responsible in what you do. You have to be responsible in what you say. Yeah? Then you must plan. You come into a club, it has no budget, it has no plan, and you're running. In Express today, you can't spend out of budget. No. If you didn't plan it, you don't spend on it. You don't get excited that all of a sudden you've got $400 million from Betway, and all of a sudden you're getting excited and now you want to have 5 pairs of boots. But you plan for 2. Get the 2. Because by the time you arrived at that, you already knew what you needed. So planning, discipline, accountability. Once you get those things together, and that's not for only Express, no club is going to survive at this level if they don't get those in place.
So 3 key items:
planning, discipline, and accountability. Without those, you're finished. And accountability comes with transparency, it comes with corporate governance, it comes with structures. You are accountable. How do you account? How did you buy these phones for the players? Oh, we sat in council. Council said this. It went to the board. The board approved it. We had money for it. Where did it come from? This is, and it was planned for. So I cannot possibly get up tomorrow morning and increase the salary of the players. No, it's not planned. You must plan. So we've gone through that process. We've planned. For this season, we have it all on a dotted line. It's very clear exactly what has to be done. So once you get those values correct, then I think you can start crawling. By the way, you must remember, I'm not saying flying, but the ego will soar one day, like I said. Right now, we are crawling.
Yeah.
We are getting through the dark space, and we are just moving up. Eventually, we shall start running. Then we shall fly.
All right. Just the other day, the Eagles had a rather fateful battle with the Venoms, but that will be a story for another day. Speaking of plans, there are Express fans out there that will know of properties their club has, sometimes in rumors, sometimes because they have it on good account. There are a couple of those that will tell you, we have land here, someday we'll have our own stadium. Do you know of any land that the club owns? And if it does, is it the stadium that is the most important thing?
Well, for you to have a stadium, you must have players to play in it. So people must always remember what the most important resource of the club is, the players. So you must start with investing in that human resource. Actually, for any business, be it a law firm, be it the television industry, human resource is the most valuable resource. So right now, at the top of my agenda, I don't have stadium as a critical aspect, but I know that in the strategic path, 3 years from now, 2 years from now, because we are going 2 seasons from now, it will be top on the agenda.
Getting a new stadium.
Getting a stadium, getting a permanent home, permanent stadium. And right now, our permanent home is anticipated to be Wankulukuku. So we are going to be having very long and tedious conversations and very involved conversation with the Kingdom of Buganda and the trustees of Nachivubo of Mutesa II Stadium to make sure that we get a working relationship. Yes, I know that there's land. I know it out of rumors. I don't have it on official account in Kanyanya. But for me, that's not, to be honest with you, I've not even spent 2 minutes even driving there or trying to figure that out, because for me that's not, it's not important right now. If the land is there, it's there. If it's not there, it's not there. So if I go there and it's there, if I go there and it's not there, it's not, it doesn't change anything at this material time. But the people, that's what I'm saying, it's accountability. When it was bought, is known. Who was in charge of it is known. If it's club land, it's known. So let them deal with that. And that's club business. That's the accountability level. That, but we must bite off as much as we can chew. So the stadium is the second most important resource available, training and playing ground. And right now, we have a very, very cordial relationship with the management of Wankulukuku, and we work together in terms of seeing that the stadium is in good condition. It is going to take time, but we will get there. But you see, the stadium also has to get money from the stadium, because Express gets very preferential terms on the use of the stadium. So we need to work within that. But it's those are the challenges that make it most exciting. You don't have a stadium, but you have to make do with what you have, and you must work together. So if you asked me where I wanted to go, I don't think I'd want to move away from Wankulukuku. But that's a decision that has to be made at a higher level than myself. It has to be a full board and the full council to sit and discuss that and determine where they want to go. But what I can tell you is that the third season in leadership, top on the agenda will be the stadium for Express.
All right. Quite the conversation we've gotten to have with council. But before we get to wind this one up, I'm going to go back to one of the first words I had when you were appointed chairman of Express. And I'll say it in Luganda, because it was said in Luganda. Ha! Wuroyobo. If you don't understand Luganda, it is these wiseacres, the lawyers, they're just going to spoil our football. How is that going for you so far?
Well, Express is a spoke in a wheel. For the league to happen, there are 15 other clubs that must participate. So I'll do my part in Express, and then the other 15 spokes will do their part, and then we'll figure it out. But for me right now, like I said, I think many people quite anticipated a totally different thing. They anticipated that I'll be at the stadium running around with the players and checking them on them at training, figuring out what they are eating. That's not my job. I'm the chairman of the club, and I'll do what I have to do. And if it is wiseacking for the purpose of Express doing what it has to do, all that I will do. For Express, that I will do.
Okay.
Yeah. And you see, the thing is that even our partners, Betway, Equity, Uganda Breweries, and Buganda Land Board, I think they like the wiseacking because they also expect of us
standards,
a high standard of accountability, a high standard of organization. So each one of them is asking, what has happened in a previous period? Where are you taking this? They have brands to keep. Are you being hooligans at the club? Are you throwing stones? Are you doing this? So they expect that, and we need to give that back to them. So really, the wiseacre is here, and the wiseacre doesn't seem to be going anywhere. I'm here for a long time. Like I keep saying, I am going to be chairman of Express for 3 years to life. So for 3 years to life.
Between three years and life. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much, yeah. KK, for getting to give us all the time.
Pleasure.
And getting to share with us the different insights on Express FC.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Well, the good things do also come to an end, and that's just what got to happen here. We've talked to KK. If you do have any other questions that you might want this gentleman to get to answer away from what we've talked about today, reach us on our Facebook, on our Twitter. We shall get to reach him, and maybe we'll come back and record those answers for you and get to bring them to you. Like he said, he's a very friendly person and not so hard to find. Well, at least if you are the media. And we shall get you all those answers if and when you want them. Desire Derek Ford Mugumisa is my name. This right here was Game On, the Express edition, and we are glad we got to bring it to you. Stay tuned to Urban Television, because yes, it starts here, and that only means that we have much more for you.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.